Welcome to Lecture Online. Here we're going to attack the concept of multiplying two vectors together. When we multiply two vectors together, we can either do that using what we call a dot product, also known as the scalar product, or the cross product. Now the cross product, that will have to wait for another series of videos. In the next set of videos, we're going to attack the cross product, but here we'll talk about the dot product or the scalar product. When you have two vectors, let's say vector A and vector B, and there's an angle theta between the two vectors, notice that the dot product, and it's denoted by a dot between the two vectors here, A dot B, or the dot product, it's equal to the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cos of the angle theta. Another way of calculating the dot product is simply taking the x component of A when A is projected onto the other vector B. So this would then be the x component of vector A if B is pointing in the x direction, and we multiply that times the magnitude of B. The x component of A is simply A times the cosine of theta times B, or we can write AB times the cosine of theta. So you get the exact same result. In essence, it is the one vector projected onto the other vector. So that length of the first vector projected onto B, multiply that times the length of B, and those two multiplications, the length of the projection of A onto B and the length of vector B together, is the dot product. Now, what happens if we see different angles? Let's say, what if the angle between them is equal to zero, so both vectors are pointing in the same direction? Well, in that case, the projection of A onto B is the full length of A, so there, A dot B, the dot product of A times B, should be the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cosine of the angle between them, which in this case is zero. The cosine of zero is one, so therefore it simply becomes A times B, which is exactly what we'd expect, since the projection of A onto B is the full length of A. But what if the angle is 90 degrees and now we want the dot product? Now notice the projection of A onto B gives you zero length, and so here we have A dot B is the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cosine of 90 degrees. And the cosine of 90 is zero, and of course zero times anything else simply gives you zero. So in that case, the magnitude of A dot B when the angle is 90 degrees is indeed just zero. What if the angle is greater than 90 degrees? Let's say 120 degrees. Well, then it becomes A dot B is the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cosine of 120 degrees, which, by the way, is a negative 0.5. So therefore, A dot B would be a negative 0.5 times the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B. And finally, what if the angle is 180 degrees, so that now they're pointing in opposite directions? Well, now the dot product will be the magnitude of A times the magnitude of B times the cosine of 180 degrees, which is negative 1, so it becomes the negative of A times B, which is exactly opposite to A times B. That's because they're pointing in opposite directions, so the magnitude is the same, just the negative sign indicating that they're pointing in opposite directions, and therefore the result is a negative AB. So why do they call a dot product also a scalar product? That's because when you multiply one vector with another vector via the dot product, the result of that is not a vector at all, it's simply a scalar quantity. So that's sometimes why they call it a scalar product, because the result of it is a scalar quantity, not a vector. Later on, when we talk about cross products, we multiply two vectors together via the cross product method, the result of that product will indeed be also another vector. But again, that's for another time. In this case, realize when you do a dot product, the result of that is a scalar quantity, and this is how you do that dot product.